Hey everyone, we're going to get a move on. I thank everyone for their patience. I'm sure a lot of you have been hanging around. I hope you've had time to enjoy and play with your new crucibles. It's awesome to have you all here, and we're extremely excited to have now hit a major milestone in the Crucible chapter with releasing what we believe to be one of the most complicated pieces of NFT art in the space. I hope today is as exciting for you all as it is for us. And I want to take a moment to thank everyone in the team and everyone that has taken part to turn this into a reality. As you can see, the artwork is more than just a JPEG. It's part of your story, and it will involve to follow your future history. I have two of our amazing team members with us here today to give you a bit more info about the story and the challenges that have been faced to make this all possible. So I'm going to pass the mic over to Hyper. Hyper, we don't seem to be able to hear you.
Hey, can you hear me now?
Yeah, can hear you loud and clear.
Okay, thank you. So, hey everyone, I'm really glad to be here and to watch your guys' reactions to the project. We've been working on it on this for such a long time, as you know, and we started with like a blank sheet in front of us and a big opportunity. And I'm very glad that we were able to create something so different and unique. We took this opportunity as far as we could and envisioned something that I haven't seen a similar project yet in the space. And I think this opportunity wouldn't have been available to us anywhere else. So I'm really grateful for the Alchemist community to be able to have given this opportunity for our team. There are many technical challenges and creative challenges involved. Doing something in real time in 3D, interactive, and using data from the blockchain on the browser is not easy. And I'm really glad that we were able to deliver this to you guys. I think it's really worth it. And there's a lot of features hidden inside of it. So, please explore your crucibles and have a good time. I'll pass it on to Ninja.
Hey guys, can you hear me?
Loud and clear.
Oh, perfect. I had to join on my phone because my laptop just won't accept the push to talk. Sorry about that, guys. I'm really excited to have you all here. I just want to take a moment to say thank you to all the community for their patience and support. I know you've all been waiting a very long time for this, and I hope you really like the outcome. And I also want to say thank you to everyone who is involved in making this artwork come to life. Like everyone on the team is really talented, and I really enjoyed working with all of you. So just a few things on sort of things that you guys might still want. So I know a lot of users might want to see their crucible on OpenSea, and that's something where we're currently working on. As soon as it's ready, we'll share the details with you guys. And I also thought maybe to talk about some of the challenges we had in terms of the development side of things. So initially, the artwork was in a completely separate project and repository to our front end. And we had to combine both projects and also teams together, which was quite challenging, but I think we did a really good job with that. And also how the data was passed to the artwork had to be completely redone. So on our site, we take great care in providing the best user experience by caching a lot of things. And we wanted to make use of that with the Crucible as well, just so things load fast and you can have a really good experience in how your crucible operates. Another feature we added, which was somewhat challenging, is the ability to view other users' crucibles. So previously, all you could do is view your own crucibles, but now you can put a crucible address and you can see, how someone's artwork looks, and also the assets that have been locked and also unlocked, which is a really cool feature, which I think you guys would really enjoy as well. So some of the other things is basically we wanted to reward users who have been participating or getting involved with the Alchemist ecosystem since the early days. And what this meant is that we needed to take into account a user's historical involvement with the project, and that meant getting historical data, which was another challenge in itself. Initially, we were doing this on the client, but we found that it wasn't a very scalable solution. So we deployed some subgraphs to handle that, and it's been working really well, and it's allowed us to accomplish what we wanted with the artwork, which is really cool. And I just want to say thank you again to everyone for their hard work, and thanks to the community for all their support. And yeah, really excited to see what we're gonna accomplish next.
Awesome, thank you, Ninja and Hyper. It's been amazing to hear your stories. Obviously, there's a little bit more in the Medium article, which has been posted in the announcements, which gives you a bit of an insight to what the Crucible is all about as well. So I do strongly recommend everyone who's here now to spend some time and look through that. I'm actually going to give you guys a live kind of demonstration of everything and try to get you familiar with also this, a few changes that we've introduced into the website. So how Crucibles will be minted moving forward, and the benefits back to the community, which these changes should also bring to you all. So I'm going to start by sharing my screen. Let me just get that open now. So I'll give it another 20 seconds or so people can connect. If you are having problems connecting, please let us know in the Alchemy channel or make your voices heard. But hopefully you guys will be able to see my screen. I don't see any complaints, so I'm guessing it's safe to assume that we're ready to go. So a few changes that you will notice on the website when you first open it is that you've now got this explore section. So what the explore section does is firstly it gives you a list of all crucibles in order of them being minted. And you can actually scroll through and choose any crucible that you like. And as you scroll, the list will get further populated. And when you do click on someone else's crucible, you can actually see their current participation, the tokens that they're holding, and also view their artwork. One of the main changes to users when they want to mint a crucible is now that there are three different tiers to do so. You have the basic option, which is really just our frictionless way to allow the Crucible project to become more adoptable to other projects in the space and also just general users. So this is the most economical way of minting a Crucible. It will just give users a very, very basic Crucible, which has no artwork. And allow the user to actually, you know, get involved with the reward programs and participate in governance and very basic functionality. So the idea here is to allow other projects to bring reward programs into our community, which they weren't able to do before because there's always been this missed ETH LP requirement. And that works as a friction against their community. And, you know, it's kind of been a pain point for them to be able to consider us. So this is hopefully going to allow us to bring far more adoption. But effectively, you know, allowing this option in the way that we have done so will protect the interests of the people who've already minted and all of you that are part of our community. So we introduced this secondary option, which is the pro version. So it does give some exclusive benefits, which currently we haven't put anything in place, but there are a lot of very, very interesting things coming. I don't want to spoil that too much, but I can say that you guys will be very excited to hear that there'll be a number of announcements coming up in the next couple of weeks. So look out for those. But what it also does do is give you the artwork and give you the basic functionalities of a normal Crucible, allow you to do those interactions. The benefit here is that the users who do take this option, they obviously have a gas saving for, you know, creating LP and other aspects. But at the same time, as with the Fractal setup, I don't know if you all voted and you were part of the Fractal profit sharing governance vote that took place. But if you weren't, then just to make you aware, 50% of all revenues that are generated are deposited back to Aladel V1.5. So what will happen in this case is anyone who mints through this, you users who have minted a Crucible with Mist ETH LP and you're still subscribed to Aladel V1.5, you will receive 50% of that revenue that's generated. So it's something to go back to the community. And then with the remainder, part of that goes back to the multisig, and the team receives 40% of the total amount that's remaining. And with that, we actually intend to obviously, give some of that to the team, but also there will be some interesting ways that we're going to give that back to Crucible holders. So we're trying to actively think about the future of how to return value back to you guys, apart from, you know, the standard obligation of Aladel V1.5. So we have some really interesting ideas, which you're, like I said, you'll be very excited to hear in the future. So with everyone who's, you know, spent the gas to get Mist ETH LP and get Mist token and mint the Crucible with, because minting with Mist ETH LP does cost a little bit more, all of you will receive the artwork absolutely free of charge. You will have this Crucible key, which is the effectively this access to those exclusive benefits. And obviously, you know, as you used Mist ETH LP, you were automatically subscribed to the Aladel. So hopefully most, or if not all of you, are still there, and you'll reap the benefits for everyone who starts joining our community from here onwards. So as I said, this is an idea to create high adoption rates. So hopefully that value will be returned back to you all as a new revenue stream. So to go to give you some idea of how Crucibles look. So this particular one is a basic one. So I just wanted to show you when you have a basic Crucible, you have to upgrade it if you wanted to receive the artwork. That fee is the same as what you've seen on the Minter Crucible screen. And as I said, you know, part of that fee will go back to you guys who are in Aladel V1.5. So I'm just going to change my wallet so you guys can see what it looks like. So you all must be familiar with the normal screens that you've seen for your summary of assets and your asset management. So one of the things we brought in is actually being able to transfer between Crucibles. So that's something that you guys will also be able to take advantage from. So if you have multiple Crucibles, you can now use this transfer function to move tokens around between your Crucibles. I'm sure you guys don't want to see any more from this side, so let's jump straight into the Crucible artwork itself. So as you can see, for those who haven't got a chance to see the Crucible or their own Crucible at this stage, this is effectively a 3D interactive piece of art, which is continuously changing. There are a lot of aspects in this artwork which is quite dynamic. And we also plan to add a lot more things in the near future. So imagine this is your base canvas. And over time, we're going to be releasing a lot more interesting things, which are going to allow your Crucible to evolve. And furthermore, there will be some kind of events which will hold, which might involve your Crucible. Or there might be some, you know, NFT drops, for example. It's just a wild idea that the team have had, which, you know, let's say, for example, you deposited that into your Crucible. it might make some significant changes to your Crucible's artwork and maybe some other aspects as well. So imagine this as a base canvas. As you can see there, you know, the gems on this one is glowing. I've had this one for a little while now. So there are a few things which I can explain to you and how they work. So the first thing is you have these rings which display on the outer section of your Crucible. This is a dynamic display of all of the USD value of your token, that tokens that are staked to reward programs. So as you can see, I'm not a very rich duck, but I have a little bit of tokens in my Crucible. So there are actually several rings, and the total that they represent is about $165,000. So the more rings you have, they represent more money, effectively, that's staked in your Crucible. You can read a bit more about that in the Medium article. So that's a very basic thing. Starting from the outside, so you have these runes. And as you can see, these are a few of them have been pressed in, and they have some visual, how would you say, projected image above them. These are achievements. So right now we have four standard achievements which are built in. You can read again a bit more about that on the article. But as you unlock more achievements based on your activity, more of these will become pressed and animated. And as I said, at the moment, there are only four which have been designed in at the moment, but we have, I believe, 26 runes to make use out of. So there'll be a lot of interesting challenges which we're going to put forward to the community to unlock those runes and the benefits which might be behind them later on. So the artwork itself, as you can see, there are many, many elements in this piece of art, starting with the lid. Every section of the lid is different. So you have a star and you have an inner, middle and an outer ring. And these are all generated alongside with these elements inside here as well, and your gems, all generated based on your Crucible token ID, the timestamp from when it's minted, the block number that it was minted in. You know, we have quite a bespoke calculation there, which will generate your traits of your Crucible, and your traits are displayed from this menu up here in the top left hand corner. And you can see the rarities of those particular items and the names that those traits have been given. So to make you aware, there are, in combination, there are over 20 billion different kind of combinations you can have as a whole, generally because there's so many different pieces to this piece of art that it makes it, have this amazing amount of combinations. But individual items, like, when you look at them in a singular approach, as I said, with traits, they have their own rarities. There are some pieces which are extremely, extremely rare. But we will release a nice little kind of document with all the rarities and all the combinations, so you guys can see like what are the must-have parts and what's the best kind of things that you can have in a Crucible. Obviously, this is still very early, but there are some other additional things we want to plan in. So this section here is the reward program item. So you have represented in there your activities with reward programs that you've taken part in. And the rings themselves represent, how much multiplier you have. And it also does affect this image here. So how bright that is will also reflect on your activity there. This is the clock. So the clock is actually interactive. You can click on it and it will give you the date that you minted and also your mint number. So pretty interesting aspect. You can click on it again and it will just resume as it was. There are a lot of interactive parts on this Crucible. So you can actually, for example, click on the ruins, which, they do some kind of animations. You can click on the gems, they do animate. You can click on, for example, this clock as well. Sorry, excuse me. Yeah, you can click on different parts of the Crucible. So I'll leave that for you all to explore. We are building extra functionality into this. So what you see now isn't only what you're going to get. We have a lot of things which have been planned in, which couldn't unfortunately make it for this MVP release, which we've done today. But we are going to gamify this a lot more, and it's going to have a lot of very interesting information displayed within your crucibles and represent a lot of more other things. So a few things that you notice. So the gems are glowing. This actually represents your historical activity in Aladels. So the level actually of your crucible is represented here, and the larger your LP is, or the larger duration that you've held for, we have a pretty nice calculation that's going on there for how the levels work. You get a slightly different representation of how your crucible will look in terms of this. So it's like a power level up aspect, and there are currently 5 tiers. So mine, I think, is a third tier possibly, but you know, there are we are also building a bit more into those. But no one, I don't think we could find one particular crucible which has passed the highest tier yet. But there are a few crucibles which are very close to that. And day by day, as you're staked in reward programs, your crucible is continuously leveling up. So that's kind of the artwork, the kind of aspects, the dynamic aspects of it. Obviously, have your crucible address, which is displayed here. These rings are also generated depending on your crucible ID. So there aren't a huge amount of different rings, but they are very unique. So a lot of you would have very different rings which are represented there. To interact with your crucible, as you see, you can open and close it. You have a lot of camera options here if you wanted to view your crucible from different positions. You can make it full screen if you wanted to and play with it a bit more. It is right now what we've released is a kind of compressed lower resolution version, just to make sure that this works for everyone. But the crucible artwork is actually extremely, extremely detailed. And over time, we're going to release a few setting options which allow you to see it. For those people with like really amazing computers or very powerful devices, you'll be able to increase the quality that's displayed and see some hidden gems which we've thrown in here as well. So just to close this and jump into showing you other people's crucibles. So if you wanted to see other people's crucibles, as I said, jump into the explore option, pick a crucible at random. This first one obviously is a Ghost Steps crucible, so Stefan's one. I think you guys will love to have a look at that one. That's a very, very unique one, and is going to be very interesting if you jump in there. I'm not going to spoil that one for everyone, but I'll try and grab one at random. Let's try this one, for example. So as you can see, as a normal user, you can see what's going on there. And the artwork, so everyone's crucible is pretty unique to some degree. Crucibles which have a very low mint number, so we have some calculation, the lower that your mint number is, the more effects of particles you have in the sky, the more kind of nebula effect you get in this space as well, which is very unique to the lower mint numbers. So, and also very interestingly, we've dropped in a nice little sticker here for the first 1,000 crucibles. So that's a very, very unique thing in there. But we do also want to have a couple of extra things which we're going to drop in the near future. So those people with low mint numbers, or those people who've minted a crucible before Aladel V1 ended, or before Aladel V1.5 started, you guys do get this extra special background and a few other extra special bits. That's also in the article. But like I said, there's going to be definitely more to come. As you can see, this crucible is a little bit different. The clock is different. Gyroscope is different. Planetary clock on this one is a little bit different as well. But like I said, most crucibles, they're going to look very different from one to another, whether it's in colors, whether it's in the actual pieces in there, whether it's the actual design of the different elements as well. So when you're viewing other people's crucibles, you can share them to Twitter if you want to. When you're having your own crucible, you can also share it to Twitter. We've given this option to share artwork only. This is the way of sharing your Crucible in a private way, because we do understand some of you people would want to share your Crucible without exposing what its contents are or exposing the address behind it. So this is a very unique generated address up here, which cannot be easily decoded to work out what the Crucible address is. And on top of that, the Crucible minting address is missing from the lid. So that kind of protects that. But all your activities and everything that's going on in your Crucible will be displayed. You can share that out to public safely and not have to worry about other people's getting access to know what your Crucible value is or the underlying token values of your Crucible are or the reward programs that you'll stake to or anything that you might feel is a little bit sensitive in that respect. So make sure you make use out of the Twitter buttons and enjoy spreading your new NFT out to the world. Just to let you know, so for the moment, the NFT artwork is only available on the website. The reason being is we have launched the Crucible contract pretty early, and we did miss a few important aspects to that. But don't worry, we are working with OpenSea and a number of other places to get the artwork displayed there. So it is a manual process. We have nearly finished all the requirements from our side, but it will take a little bit of time before your artwork is visible on OpenSea and other places. But when it does become visible on OpenSea, OpenSea will be fully interactable. So you will see your Crucible with its movements, with all the happenings that that are going on there, and people will be able to interact with it. Yeah, so don't worry, that's something to look forward to. We're not quite there yet, but we're definitely pushing as hard as we can to make sure that will be done ASAP. So yeah, so you can also share your full details, so that will give people access to everything that your Crucible does, so or is currently doing. So I'll just share that with you guys here. Works very similar to the Explore tab. So this is like a public view. So as you can see, users can see my locked assets. Obviously, they can't withdraw my assets or do anything silly with them, but they can see like what my participation was in reward programs. And then also view my artwork. So it's you know, an option that you guys could take benefit out of as well, if you wanted to let people know the exact intricacies behind your Crucible. Yeah, so all of this stuff that you see, apart from the rings, which are these rings here, is permanent to your Crucible, but they do level up. So if you remove your stakes, so if you have stake to any of these reward programs and you decide to leave them, you won't lose your coins, you won't lose your activity, you won't lose your emissive effects, or you know, these particle effects which are higher level, or there are some other more special effects which you guys will have to discover as time goes, but you won't lose those will stay with your Crucible forever. So even if you decided to part ways with your Crucible, the next owner will take over from wherever you left off. So I believe I've probably rambled on way too long. So let me just double check with the schedule what we're looking to do. Oh, so we're just about on time to open, I guess, an AMA side. So this channel is Push to Talk. So if anyone wanted to, I don't know how we're going to handle this in here, because it's probably going to be a bit of chaos. Yeah, I think maybe we should jump over to the stage. I don't know if you guys can see the community stage. It hides under the Alchemist radio section. If we all jump into the community stage and we'll give it a couple of minutes, then we can have a nice Q&A with the people involved. And I'm sure you guys have a lot of questions, and then we'll take it from there. So thanks everyone for listening to my explanation. I know it's been very long. But let's jump into the community stage. We'll wait a few minutes and we'll take it from there.